गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास. आर टुडेज टॉपिक इज डीएनए द जेनेटिक मटेरियल. एक्चुअली डीएनए इज द जेनेटिक मटेरियल इज प्रूव्ड बाय अल्फर्ड हर्शे एंड मार्था चेज ड्यूरिंग 1952. Both the scientists work on bacteriophages, we can say it T2 viruses. That viruses infect bacterial cell by inserting its genetic material. The viral genome became the part of bacterial genome and it manufactures more viruses particle. Hershey and Chase worked together to discover whether it was protein or DNA from the viruses that inserted into the bacterial host cell. The viral genetic material became the part of a bacterial genome and it manufactures more virus particles by using the host content or host DNA. Hershey and Chase experiment is also called blunder experiment, through which they saw that phages only injected the DNA into host bacteria and that the DNA served as the replicating genetic element of phages. They performed the experiment actually in three steps. One step, first step is infection, second is blending, and third one is centrifugation. They are using actually blender in the second step, that's why this experiment is known as blender's experiment. In the first step, they grew some viruses on a medium having radioactive phosphorus and some other viruses grown on medium having radioactive sulfur. Actually, we know that the phosphorus is responsible to create the structure of DNA and the sulfur is the part of protein. Viruses that grow in radioactive phosphorus have radioactive DNA but not radioactive protein, because the phosphorus present in DNA, not in the protein. Viruses that grow in radioactive sulfur have radioactivity in the protein but not radioactivity in the DNA, because sulfur present in protein but not present in the DNA. Here is the picture of the slide. You can see the first step infection. The radioactive phages were allowed to infect the E. coli bacteria. Now, the phages transfer their genetic material to the bacterial or the host cell. The viral coats were separated from the bacterial surface by the blender. The virus particles were separated from the bacteria by centrifuge machine. After the centrifugation, they observed their result. What are the observations? Number one, the bacteria infect with viruses that have radioactive DNA were radioactive. No radioactivity in the supernatant. And the bacteria infected with the virus that had radioactive protein were not radioactive, but the radioactivity is found in the supernatant. Now, what is the conclusion of this experiment? The DNA is the infecting agent that made the bacteria radioactive, hence the DNA is the genetic material and not the protein. After the experiment of Hershey and Chase, What is the criteria for the genetic materials? How can we say that it is a genetic material? Point number one, that it should be able to generate its replica. Means if there is replication, then it is known as the genetic material. So no replication is found in the protein, but DNA have replication. It should be chemically and structurally stable, and it should provide slow changes. If the slow changes is there, means the mutation is there that required for the evolution process, it is a genetic material. Next point is a very important, that if it is able to express itself in form of Mendelian character, means if there is Mendel's law is going to be proved, then it is a genetic material. And if protein does not fulfill, the protein does not fulfill the criteria, hence it is not the genetic material. But the RNA and DNA, both the nucleic acids can fulfill the criteria, all the criteria, so it is known as the genetic materials. And at the last stage of their experiment, they have proven that the DNA is the genetic material and not the protein. So RNA and DNA fulfill all the criteria that it is the genetic material that can transfer from generation to generation. So, thank you. Have a nice day.